I'm on the Tokyo Metro Ginza Line train bound for Asakusa. The Ginza Line was the first subway to open in Japan. After the first section opened in 1927, the line was gradually extended, and the entire line opened in 1939. The next station is Ginza, where the name of the line later came from. It connects with Hibiya Line and Marunouchi Line. In 2017, nearly 90 years after the opening of Ginza Station in 1931, renovations began on the station. It completed by 2020, and the Ginza Line platform has a chic interior. The Ginza Line has 6 16-meter cars and a total length of 96 meters, about 315 feet, so the platform is very compact. Let's get off at the platform. This is the front of the Ginza Line platform. Here is a map of the station. The three lines that enter are lined up in an H shape centering on the Hibiya Line station. From now on, I will look at the premises in order of the Ginza Line, the Hibiya Line, and the Marunouchi Line. There is a board on the wall that describes the history of the Ginza Line. More than 80 years have passed since the entire line opened, and each station on the Ginza Line is undergoing renovation. After consolidating multiple stations, they decided on a concept such as a downtown area, a business area, etc., and then renovated. However, Ginza Station is not grouped with other stations and is treated specially. I arrived at the back of the platform. The board on the wall progresses in age as it goes backwards. The one on this side is until 1990, and the continuation moves to the opposite platform, turning around and continuing to where I was earlier. The ticket gate floor is above this.
Let's go back a little and go up the stairs. The Ginza Line trains and tunnels are compact, so the stairs are short. The ceiling and floor are finished with black materials and tiles, and in this video it looks fairly bright, but partly because there aren't many lights, it actually feels darker. This is the ticket gate for the Ginza Line and Hibiya Line. Because it is underground and has poor visibility, and a complex structure with intricate underground passages, concentric circle patterns were placed on the floor during renovations to imply where the center of the station is. In addition, this ticket gate has a lemon-yellow lighting that is conscious of the Ginza Line, and the line name is indicated by color. Above this is the Ginza 4 Chome intersection, known for Ginza Wako, a commercial facility that symbolizes Ginza. The name of this ticket gate is also Ginza 4 Chome Crossing Ticket Gate, and the building that can be seen when you go out to the ground is drawn on the ceiling. And the passage on this level continues on the platform of each line, and if you go up the stairs next to the leading car and turn around, you can come to the same ticket gate. The interior of that passage is different from here, probably because it belongs to a nearby department store. Further down that passage is Ginza Ichome Station on the Yurilacho line. You can transfer at Ginza Station, but you need to go through the ground. I returned to the previous ticket gate. In order to secure the space of the ticket gate, the aisle is avoided on the left. The underground passage directly above the Hibiya line continues from Higashi Ginza next door, and the ticket gates are set to cut into the passage. The concentric circles on the floor seem to have a certain effect.
Let's go to the platform of the Hibiya line. The platform for the Ginza line is on the second basement floor, and the platform for the Hibiya line is on the third basement floor. It was a circuitous flow line that went up to the first basement floor and then went down to the third floor. This flow line branches off on the second basement floor, so when transferring between the Ginza and Marunouchi lines, you don't have to go through the Hibiya line platform, so you don't get caught up in congestion. The passage outside the ticket gate extends up this, so if you go from the Ginza line side to the Marunouchi line platform further back, you do not need to enter the ticket gate and go through the Hibiya line platform on the third basement floor. This platform has also been renewed, and platform doors were installed last year. Higashi Ginza Station is next to the Hibiya line, but there is no Nishi-Ginza Station nearby. Now that Tokyo's subway system has developed, it is not uncommon to see a station with three lines, but did you know that the construction of this station required many hardships? It is on the platform of the Hibiya line where I am now. Looking at the ground, you can see that the station facilities are narrow compared to the width of the road. This is not because the road was widened after opening, but because the tunnel was made narrower than the road from the beginning. This platform gets crowded during rush hour. Why is it so narrow?
Ginza Station on the Hibiya Line opened in August 1964. Of the three existing stations with the name Ginza, it was restarted as a general station connecting the stations of the same company. The reason why there is no Nishi-Ginza Station in the vicinity is that the former Marunouchi Line station was incorporated into Ginza Station. The completed station is huge as a single station of the company and was designed with special A-class treatment. At the time of construction of the Ginza Line, the construction of the tunnel for the Hibiya Line had already been completed. It was decided to set up a tunnel for the Hibiya Line on the third basement floor, under the tunnels for both the Ginza and Marunouchi lines on the second basement floor, and a concourse on the first basement floor. The area directly above the tunnel of the Hibiya Line is used as a machine room and a station office, except for the aisle mentioned earlier, and the space is effectively used. However, this seemingly sensible plan has its drawbacks. That is the construction of the underground expressway that the Tokyo Metropolitan Government was promoting at that time. This would connect about 1.3 kilometers across Ginza Station and was planned to be installed on the first basement floor. However, the tunnels on both the Ginza and Marunouchi lines are located in shallow places, and it is not possible to secure a sufficient height for a car tunnel. The concourse of Ginza Station would be cut off by a car tunnel, which will reduce the efficiency of use. Also, the tunnels on both the Ginza and Marunouchi lines did not take into consideration the load of cars. The plan had to be changed. It was to dig tunnels for automobiles on both sides of the Hibiya Line tunnel, and at this time, the width of the Hibiya Line platform was revised from 14 meters to 9 meters, about 46 feet to 30 feet. However, this plan was also shelved due to many problems in terms of project costs and communication with neighboring buildings, and in the end, only a small road tunnel was built on the west side of Ginza Station. However, it was in November 1962 that the plan change on the roadside was finalized, after construction of the Hibiya Line had already begun. If the design was changed, it would not be in time for the Tokyo Olympics in October 1964, so the Hibiya Line opened with a platform width of 9 meters, about 30 feet. The reason why the station was not built across the width of the road was due to the conflict between the road plan and the construction period. In addition, although it was an intersection with the Ginza Line that had been made in advance, the height was insufficient because the third rail system was expected at the time, so the top and bottom were shaved and reinforced. On the west side of the station, there were pillars of the expressway, a water tank for firefighting, and the remains of a bridge that once existed. The construction of the first general station and the Hibiya Line was extremely difficult. Despite this, construction progressed, and the opening of the facility was completed just in time, just over a month before the Tokyo Olympics. Let's go on the platform. The lighting on the pillars of the Hibiya Line platform is based on a silvery white color scheme, which emphasizes the line color of the Hibiya Line. The flow line from the Hibiya Line platform to the ticket gate is not only at both ends of the platform, but also in the middle. Before going to the Marunouchi Line platform, let's go up here once. The elevator ahead is an afterthought, but the escalator has been there since the opening, and you can see the ingenuity to handle passengers with the width of the platform, which cannot be said to be sufficient. Here, although it is connected to the aisle that split earlier, it seems that not many people pass through because of its structure. Unlike the ticket gate on the Ginza Line side, it is quite bright. The name of this ticket gate is the Central Gate. Due to its location, only the Hibiya Line is guided, and it is more convenient to enter the ticket gate after proceeding through the underground passage on this level to both the Ginza and Marunouchi lines. Of course, there is also a guide to the surrounding buildings. In contrast to the Ginza Line side, where the floor, ceiling, and building guide were circular, the squares here stand out. And at the foot of the elevator that goes down from here, there is a reserved seat ticket vending machine for the TH Liner, a paid seat reserved train on the Hibiya Line. At this point, go outside the ticket gate. In fact, there is a certain monument between the ticket gate on the Marunouchi Line side of the connecting passage on the first basement floor. This is Noritsugu Hayakawa, the father of the subway. He is the founder of the Tokyo Underground Railroad, which built the first section of the Ginza Line to open. He is called the father of the subway because he worked hard to open the first subway in Japan. At Ginza Station, which has a chic atmosphere, it doesn't stand out a bit, but he is still watching over the safety of the subway. and working spaces are also installed in the surrounding passages, and they play a role that is not just a passage. Let's return to the platform. The escalator that connects directly from the basement floor to the third floor is not that long, but it has quite an impact. The area that connects to the connecting passage on the second basement floor is surrounded by glass, and the impression is different from the previous one. And when the Hibiya Line opened, it was an 8-car train of 18-meter cars, with a total length of 144 meters, about 470 feet. Currently, the train consists of 7 20-meter cars, with a total length of 140 meters, about 460 feet. Although it is 4 meters, about 13 feet shorter, the number of doors has increased from 24 to 28, and the number of connecting surfaces between cars has been reduced, which has eased congestion. At the end of the escalator is the end of the platform, which leads to the concourse on the Marunouchi Line side. At the end of the escalator, there are members arranged in a triangular shape that is different from the previous one. The connecting passage on the second basement floor does not join in the middle, and goes up to the concourse side side by side over the wall. Passages outside the ticket gates on both sides have also been added, making it lively all at once. Although it is a bright color based on white, the concourse is chic. Unlike the concentric circles of the Ginza Line and the square Hibiya Line, the Marunouchi Line is laid out in triangles. The surrounding guide is also a triangle. Ginza Station, where the shapes of the components differ depending on the location, is around here. And the name of the ticket gate here is Sukiyabash Intersection Ticket Gate. Sukiyabash is the name of the bridge that once spanned here. Its remains were found during the construction of the Hibiya Line. Let's go back to the Ginza 4 Chome Intersection Ticket Gate near the Ginza Line, walk through the passage outside the ticket gate on the first basement floor, and walk to the Sukiyabashi Intersection Ticket Gate. The station itself has a simple H-shaped structure, but in addition to the intricate underground passages and ticket gates, the passages outside the ticket gates also have steps and slopes, making it a rather complicated flow line. If an underground expressway had been built here, it would have been more complicated than it is now, and it seems that it would not have been able to play the role of a general station. I'll keep walking, passing the statue of Noritsugu Hayakawa. Is it possible to use it as a small event space because there is a space in the middle? And this passage, the height becomes lower as you go to the back. The number of stairs is higher than on the Ginza Line side, and you can see that the structure is not so simple. Also, what I saw just for a moment was the Nishi-Ginza parking lot. The reason why the plan for the underground expressway was greatly reduced was that if a road were built next to the Hibiya Line tunnel on the third basement level, it would not be possible to connect with these buildings and parking lots. Also, here is the passage from the Marunouchi Line side on the second basement floor, one level above the Hibiya Line. This floor has machine rooms, and the passage width is not so wide. There is also a station office on the way, and although it is an important place, barrier-free routes are limited, and while it exists as a transfer route, it feels like it is overshadowed. However, the toilet inside the ticket gate at Ginza Station is only here. It seems that the space was narrow, and it could not be placed on the same level as the ticket gate. Let's return to the Marunouchi Line side and head to the Marunouchi Line platform. In contrast to the dimmed concourse, the Marunouchi Line platform is bright, which is a little surprising. However, there is of course design, such as the effective use of spotlights. Speaking of spotlights, the lights on the platform of Ginza Station have spotlights at the openings of the platform doors, visually suggesting where the doors open. Proceed toward Ikebukuro on the Marunouchi Line platform. The platform itself is generally straight, but only the Marunouchi Line has a large curve in front and behind the station. The trains on the Marunouchi Line consist of 6 18-meter cars with a total length of 108 meters, about 350 feet. The trains on the Marunouchi Line are one size larger than those on the Ginza Line, which also uses the third rail system, which is probably why the premises feel more spacious. And this platform is just a few minutes walk from Yurakucho Station, and the distance from Ginza Ichome Station is not much different. It makes sense that this station, located at the edge of the area that bears the name of Ginza, was given the name of Nishi-Ginza. At that time, there were no complex stations like this in central Tokyo, and the Toden still remained. Ginza and Nishi-Ginza stations, which are nearly 300 meters apart and were not connected underground, were never considered to be the same station. Moreover, the alignment of the train, which passes through the National Railway at the time twice, before and after the station, was decided before construction and unexpectedly at a later stage. The Marunouchi Line was once planned to pass through Kanda Station, just like the Ginza Line. At the time when the subway network was still thin, the plan was to increase the number of connecting stations. Because the roads around Kanda Station were narrow, the route went through Awajicho and Otemachi. And there was also a plan to take the course to the west at the end of Tokyo Station. This plan was shelved due to the inability to secure land, and in the end, it was decided that it would be preferable to go via Ginza, which had been one of Tokyo's busiest districts since that time. It has become the current alignment that passes under the elevated railway twice, and a facility that is different from the Ginza and Hibiya lines, which have straight platforms directly under the road. And while you tend to pay attention to its convenient location and beautiful facilities, do you know the other meaning behind this entire facility? A pillar with line color that appeared from the beginning. If you look closely at the pattern on the pillar near the Tsukiyabashi crossing ticket gate, you can see that the lines are entwined. Yes, it's M in Marunouchi. Similarly, the Hibiya line is H and the Ginza line is G, and you can feel the commitment of Tokyo Metro that you do not notice just by walking. The use of circles, rectangles, and triangles in the interior design of each line may also be in harmony with this motif. At the time of construction, this station had a lot of trouble with the layout of the premises, so as not to block the flow of underground passages. The location is excellent, and it's an easy-to-reach station, so be sure to check out the ingenuity of the layout of the premises and the history of hardships. Thank you for watching.